Alder Lake is shaping up to be a monumental release for Intel. Not only do all three 12th Gen CPU exceed expectations, but they're heralds of technologies like DDR5 and PCIe 5.0. Purchasing one means you'll also need to get a new motherboard, and your existing cooler might not be able to handle it either. In this video, we're going to showcase the best LG A1700 CPU coolers available on the market today. If you want more information and updated pricing on the products mentioned, be sure to check the links in the description box below. The fifth product in this list is EK240MM AIOD RGB. EK240MM AIOD RGB is a mid-sized offering with attractive RGB lighting, decent cable management, and a straightforward approach to cooling. It's the AIO to get if you can find one at MSRP. EK is another manufacturer dissatisfied with Aztec's pump design monopoly. While not as outlandish as the liquid freezers, the pump has a unique cube-like design with a prominent white cover. It houses several LEDs whose diffuse light creates a pleasant effect. The copper plate is rounded and polished close to a mirror finish. You can install the unit in 90-degree increments, which comes in handy if there's not enough clearance for memory or VRM heatsinks. The radiator is intriguing because it's less dense than usual and comes with a sealed cap. Its fin density is 17 instead of 20 to 21 you'd expect from 240mm AIO. That isn't necessarily bad since fans with lower CFM can expel air without struggling due to high resistance. Such is the case with the 120mm Varder S fans the AIO ships with. They're thin and transparent to let RGB lighting through. Setting the DRGB up shouldn't take long or present you with unforeseen complications. The tubing is flexible and long enough to reach towards a case's ceiling without issue. Don't worry about excessive cable clutter either, since there are enough splitters in the box to reduce the mess down to single PWM and ARGB connections. While RGB is implemented well, EK doesn't provide a program that would let you tinker with it. Fortunately, motherboard software like Aura Sync or RGB Fusion recognizes and incorporates it into your overall lighting scheme. Performance-wise, the AIO is a strong contender for the best LG A1700 cooler in the 240mm category. It's slightly louder than comfortable if pushed to 100% RPM and gets close to 50 dB. That's a rare occurrence though. The fans don't generate much noise at lower RPM, yet keep temperatures in check successfully. Up next, in the fourth place we have Noctua NHD15. The iconic NHD15 has been the apex of CPU air cooling since its release. You might not be able to cool the generation's flagship with it anymore, but Noctua's cooler should be more than enough for a 12,700K build. Whether they had one or not, anyone who's built a PC in the last 10 years will instantly recognize a Noctua CPU cooler. Love it or hate it, the combination of beige and medium brown on Noctua fans leaves a lasting impression. Size is another factor, since the NHD15 is huge, even if you choose only to use one of its two fans. Much of the size is down to the elaborate heatsink. It's made up of two sets of 4-5 fins, the bottom seven of which are shorter to let you reach memory sticks more easily. There's a subtle dip in the middle and a set of tooth-like markings to the side. These improve turbulence and increase the fan's effectiveness. The cooler's bottom is plated in nickel and made up of a thick base plate with six copper heat pipes. The pipes arc outward from the plate and are angled apart. The fact that the pipes are soldered to each fin is a testament to Noctua's engineering excellence and attention to detail. The fans are an improvement upon those seen on the NHD14. Their designation is NFA15, which denotes the increased 150mm diameter. Such a size increase allows for slower operation. Indeed, the fans are among the slowest on the list, with an RPM range from 300 to 1,500. Each also comes with an RPM limiter that brings the RPM down to 1,200 with a corresponding decrease in noise. Unhindered, either fan can move 82 cubic feet of air per minute. You'd think that the NHT15 size would make setting it up a pain, but it's actually among the best LG A1700 CPU coolers installation-wise. Turbulence and increase the fan's effectiveness. The new backplate and mounting hardware don't alter the installation process, which you can complete in minutes if you set up CPU coolers before. Keep in mind that the large footprint might not be compatible with tall ORAM or cramped motherboards. The third product in our list is Arctic Liquid Freezer 2280. Arctic's AIO are so good that we could almost put together a list of the best LG A1700 CPU coolers from nothing but liquid freezer models. The line encompasses everything from 120mm starters to 420mm behemoths. We're focusing on the 280mm version, since it offers the best bang for your buck while being able to tame any Alder Lake chip. It's not the flashiest AIO around, but nothing comes close in terms of performance per dollar. Almost nothing about the Liquid Freezer 2 is conventional. It makes sense when you consider that Arctic didn't want to be tied down by patent law and developed the AIO without third-party assistance. The pump head is its most prominent and unusual feature. It's elongated, has a low profile, and takes up more space than usual. The latter is due to a 40mm variable RPM fan designed to blow air over the VRM assembly. Most radiators don't stray from the 27mm norm, yet this one is a whole 11mm thicker. That means you'll have to make sure your case can support its unusual dimensions. Still, the added surface area is worth it since it draws heat away from the CPU faster. A pair of P14 fans take care of air expulsion efficiently, even though they rotate more slowly and have a lower CFM than those on our first two picks. You'll appreciate the Liquid Freezer Poo. If you're apprehensive about installing an AIO, the fans are already on the radiator. So you're only left with securing the pump head if you're good with the push configuration. The tubing's thick sleeves have enough room to route the fan's PWM cables. These come together in the pump head, so you'll only have to use one of your motherboard's PWM headers. Arctic's AIO is considerably cheaper than the best Z690 coolers we've covered so far. Much of that has to do with stripping it down to the bare essentials without sacrificing efficiency. In fact, testing shows it to be consistently quieter and cooler than most alternatives, regardless of price. Up next in the second place is the Corsair ICUE H115 iElite Capelix. Corsair is another company whose AIO combine exceptional results with creative playfulness. The newest line of H-series models incorporates proprietary LED and boasts more related configuration options than ever before. Tweaking also extends to performance, so the H115i can either cool an overclocked i9-12900K or be whisper quiet when the CPU isn't experiencing load. Unlike ASTIC-based AIO, the H115i has a square-shaped CoolIT CPU block with chamfered edges. The customary plastic top gives way to black acrylic with a transparent Corsair logo. The effect is already striking, but you can open the top up even more by switching to an inverse cap that's part of the accessories. The copper contact plate on the bottom has a machined look and comes with a generous portion of pre-applied thermal compound. Unique lighting sets the H115i apart and helps justify its above-average price. Corsair developed the Capelix LED for their excellent RAM kits first, but quickly saw the potential for AIO application. The lights occupy significantly less space than ordinary ones while using less power. That allowed Corsair to place 33 of them inside the CPU block and 8 more on each fan. The H115i keeps cable clutter in check through a commander core. This hub provides power for the fans and their LED. It requires a single USB connection to your motherboard and can support 4 more related fans. Tinkerers will find that ICUE is a wonderland for lighting customization. It can assign individual colors for each fan LED or the pump head's 21 zones. Moreover, there are dozens of effects to choose from, and you can create new ones as well. None of that would be enough to place the H155i among the best LGA 1700 CPU coolers were it not for its raw power and ICUE cooling profiles. Setting the A/IO to extreme causes temperatures to plummet, albeit at the cost of a lot of noise. On the other hand, the quiet preset maintains great cooling results while keeping sound to a minimum. Most users will stick to balance since it strikes a favorable compromise between the two. Before we reveal number one, be sure to subscribe if you want to stay up to date on the best products on the market. Finally, our top CPU cooler is the NZXT Kraken Z63. NZXT went the extra mile with the Z63, a 280mm A/IO whose pump head holds an elaborate LCD screen. That's enough to pass the cooler off as a novelty. However, the Z63 lands at the top of our best LGA 1700 CPU cooler list on account of its excellent performance. NZXT also offers coolers without as much bling that are equally effective, so check those out if you don't want to spend as much. Owners of Kraken A/IO ending in a 2 won't notice much of a difference. We'd go as far as calling the assembly uninspired before the screen is on. Astute observers will spot one subtle change. The pump head is now larger to accommodate the 2.36 screen on its top. Otherwise, it's still an Aztec cylindrical model with swivel fittings and two ports for power and USB cables set at a 90-degree angle that alleviates cable clutter. The radiator and fans do all the heavy lifting. The former is thicker than usual at 30mm and has NZXT embossed as its only decoration. It's a 280mm unit that fits two Air P140mm fans. These rotate relatively slowly yet can put out 98 cubic feet per minute of air each. They're more than a match for the thicker radiator and any case whose fans don't provide optimum airflow, combined with decent static pressure. While efficient at whisking heat away from your CPU, the Z63 is all about customization and style. The screen has a resolution of 320x320, is small enough for the images, GIFs, or real-time info it displays to be crisp and legible. The Kraken Z63 has another ace up its sleeve, NZXT Cam. The companion software is designed as a polished system monitoring tool you can use even if you don't have an associated cooler. Installing the Kraken opens up more exciting options like pump adjustments and the ability to change what's shown on the display. Info geeks and overclockers are bound to get a kick out of the real-time setting that lets you see temperatures or workloads. You may also set the screen to change colors based on the results. That's all for now. Thanks for watching. If we helped you out in any way, please hit the like and subscribe button. We'll see you guys in the next videos.